When should you choose HTMX over React and vice versa? I recently faced that choice at work, and I thought it might be helpful for you to discuss why we chose HTMX in this case. So what were the problems that we were facing? Well, let's set the context. I work at EcoTree, which is an e-commerce website. Since I didn't create the company, I inherited the backend stack that uses PHP in a framework called Symfony. Now, there is a customer area where you can manage everything you've purchased and you can create gifts to send out. That functionality requires intricate interactions and a polished user experience. So we use React to code it. That part of the website is behind an authentication gate. It's not intended to be indexed by search engines. This means it doesn't matter as much that it takes a second or two to load. However, we do want Google to index and rank the rest of the website. For SEO purposes, page speed counts. We want the website to load as fast as possible. Therefore, we render the page server-side. We use Symfony's templating engine called Twig. Most of the content on the page is static. However, this is an e-commerce website, so each page displays the basket. And when the user adds or removes articles from the basket, we want the basket's counter and content to be updated. Currently, this relies on an ancient jQuery library called SimpleCart that is no longer supported. That library stores data on the user's browser using local storage. However, this means that if the client doesn't go through with a purchase, we don't know about it. We can't let the user know that the articles that they intended to purchase is about to be sold out because we don't know what the user has added to their cart. We can't detect in the data if there's a problem in the user experience between adding cart articles to the cart and checking out, because we don't know which users have added articles to the cart. This means that we need to move the data to the server. Now, we explored three ways to do this. The first was to update the page using server-side rendering. When an item is added or removed from the basket, we could request a new page and have the server refresh that page completely. However, that would produce an uncomfortable user experience with a white page flash on every interaction. We don't want that. We want the user experience to be as smooth as possible. The second option is to wire everything up with React and to use it to interact with a server-side API. That might allow us to produce the user experience that we want. However, it does have two problems. The first is that in my experience, React apps tend to get bloated. We add this library and that library, and before you know it, you have a big bundle of JavaScript to download. That slows down the page and hurts our SEO and conversion rates. The bundle size could be solved with a lot of discipline, but there is another problem. Let's take a look at a generic landing page. We have our content, and then in the middle of the page, we have a section that shows articles that you can buy. Now, when we click on the Add to Cart button, three things should happen. First, we want a pop-up to appear that asks you if you want to go to checkout or if you want to continue purchase. We also want the counter badge on the cart icon to update. And thirdly, we want the content of the cart dropdown to be updated too. Now, we have UI components in completely different places on the page that need to be connected together. This same structure is repeated across different pages. Plugging all these things together with React would be complicated because the UI is split over different places. That's why, even though we already use React elsewhere in the customer area, we decided to use HTMX for this functionality. It allows us to connect our different user interface elements and update the display based on server-side logic. Using HTMX, we wire the click on the Add to Cart button to send a message to the server, and then we use the response to update parts of the interface, the cart and the dropdown. HTMX allows us to connect different interface elements in a static page based on the server state without reloading the whole page. In short, HTMX was a better solution here for us than React or than other front-end frameworks. For managing interface updates based on server-side state, i.e. significant state, when connecting different UI elements that are split out over a mainly static page. However, it is worth noting here that HTMX is not suited for managing transient or pure UI state. For example, we don't use HTMX to manage whether the cart dropdown is open or not. That would be overkill. This also means that complex interfaces where the user needs immediate feedback, where interactivity is more important than data security, would be more difficult to implement in a pure HTMX context. Which is why in the React versus HTMX debate, we're actually choosing both depending on the use case, depending on where we are in the website. Now, let me know what you think and what you're intending to choose or to learn. And if you're interested in learning more about HTMX or about React, well, I've got just the video for you here. I'll see you there.